Hello guys, good evening. Today in this video, what we are going to see, it's the envelope theorem and its application in economics. So first, we will see what is envelope theorem. So envelope theorem basically shows you the change in the optimal value of a particular function when a parameter of the function changes. I'm sure it's not very clear definition, but as we move ahead with this topic, we will understand more that what I'm trying to say. So speaking of the definition again, if we say envelope theorem shows you the gives you the optimum value of a particular function when a particular parameter changes. So just for the example, take this function like v and its parameter price. We want to find out the optimal value for v when price changes. Price is one of the parameter here that we can depict through envelope theorem. Envelope theorem has very wide prevalent use everywhere. So what you see, the derivation of Roy's identity, Hoetling lemmas, Seifert lemmas, and even as well as the interpretation of Lagrange multipliers, all are the special case of envelope theorem. So how do we arrive at envelope theorem, and how do we proceed on that? So first point, in order to understand it, we need to understand what is a maximum value function. Maximum value function is an objective of function where the choice of variable have assigned their optimal value. So this is a kind of indirect function. If you have seen or know about the indirect utility function, you will know the indirect utility function are derived by where the choice variable have assigned their optimum value, and then it is fed back to your utility function. So for the given function, if you want to maximize this function, what we are going to do, we will do, if you want to maximize it with respect to x, then we will find out derivative of x and we'll do it 0, and then similarly we'll find derivative of y and make it 0. So now this is my derivative. These two are equal to 0. Fx, fy, xyp. So now if I want to, x and y are variable and p is the parameter here. So I can express x in terms of function of p. Similarly, y in terms of, so I can express x in terms of p parameter and y in terms of p parameter. So this x star and y star basically will give me maximum of v. So now when I exchange the v star with this x star and y star, so this function becomes my maximum value function, and this maximum value function also called your indirect objective function. So now what is the significance of indirect objective function? So for any optimization problem, your direct objective function is maximized or minimized for a given set of parameter. So you get the given set of parameter, which is your x and y. For different p, you will get different set of x and different set of y. For this different set of parameter, you get maximized direct function. So now when you put this different set, this map, parameter into direct function, that become your indirect objective function, which will give you all maximum value of objective function as these parameters vary. So it will give you maximum value of objective function when these parameters vary. So basically your indirect objective function is an envelope of set of optimized objective function generated by varying parameter of the model. So I'll repeat it again. Your indirect objective function is an envelope of set of optimized objective function generated by varying parameter of the model. Now let's go back to our indirect objective function which we derived earlier. Now if we want to maximize this function, we will do dv by dp as is a function of p. So this is the differentiation when you do in terms of p for this function. So this is your chain differentiation. You can Google and find out how to differentiate such a function where you have one independent and one dependent variable, and how the chain reaction, chain differentiation is applied here. Now, if you do this part, this is fx into dx by dp. This part is fy. And then you have fp, which is your differentiation with respect to p. So now fx is 0. We have seen this. Fy is 0. So this whole thing becomes 0. So essentially, your dv versus differentiation by dp becomes your fp. So if you see that this result, what it says at optimum, when you derive the optimum value for the function, what matters only is your p here. You have x star, you have y star, but they are like constant. Their change doesn't impact your optimum value. So your optimum value only depends on the change in the price, change in parameter p. So if you see parameter p here, parameter p enter in this indirect function in two different way. It enters through x, it enters through y, and it enters directly p. So there are two indirect through x and y and one direct. So if you see the optimum function, only direct is only direct parameter you need to consider. The other indirect parameter are not considered here, or are not, the effect is not, is like constant. So only direct effect of the parameter is considered for optimum value of the function. So basically, that is what is the essence of your envelope theorem. Your envelope theorem says that only the direct effects of a change in an exogenous variable needs to be considered. Even though the exogenous variable may enter the maximum value function directly as part of solution to the endogenous choice variable. So that is your essence of envelope theorem. Only the direct variable or direct parameter change that impacts. Other indirect are ignored and does not impact your optimum value. So we have seen what is envelope theorem. Now we'll see what is the special cases of envelope theorem which we will be using for different application in economic theory, either in expenditure function or minimizing, maximizing profit function or expenditure function. We have Hotelling lemma and Shepherd lemma. So what is Hotelling lemma and Shepherd lemma? Hotelling lemma is basically your profit. It's associated with your profit function, while Shepherd lemma is associated with expenditure function. Hotelling lemma, what happens, change in the profit, what is the change in the profit when you change the price, it defines that. So basically, when you change the price, your change in the profit is proportional to your quantity. Similarly, Shepherd lemma, change in the cost when you change in the input price, that is proportional to your input quantity. So both are the same function. Basically, one is a profit, another depends on your expenditure function. So what would be my profit function? Profit function will be my price into quantity minus cost into quantity. So price is your selling price and your cost price. So if you subtract that, you will get your profit. So if I want to find out what is the change in profit by change in price, so this will give you quantity, and there is no price function here, so zero. So this is basically quantity. So that is what your Hotelling lemma say. So any change in price with respect to any change in profit with respect to change in price is proportional to your quantity. So just consider a small example where you for good A, your cost is 1 and price is 2 and quantity is 10. So what would be your profit? Price into quantity 2 minus and 1 into 10 equal to 10. Now if you change price from 2 to 3, your new profit will be 3 into 10 minus 1 into 10, which is equal to 20. So your change in profit, which is dpi with respect to dp, will be 20 minus 10. Earlier new profit is 20 and old profit is 10. And your price, new price is 3 minus old price is 2, which gives you 10, which is basically your quantity. So that is what your Hodling lemma is. So yeah, that is what your Hodling lemma says that. So any change in your profit with respect to price is proportional to your quantity. So what we saw, Hodling lemma is a very simple function we have seen here. So what we saw, that price is just one quantity and price, there is no function, it doesn't have any dependency. So it is a very simplistic version of Hodling lemma. So we'll see your profit function when you have the proper dependency, when your wages on your capital, on your labor and your rent. So this is where we'll see how the envelope theorem application comes, or how it is a special case of envelope theorem. So if your function is your profit function, this is price into your output function, which is dependent on your K and L, which is function of capital and labor, minus your cost. Cost will be wage into labor minus rent into capital. Now in order to maximize the profit, we will just take the partial differentiation with respect to L. So that will become your P into FL, which will be partial differentiation of this FKL with respect to L minus W equal to 0. Similarly, with respect to K, this will be the function. So if we solve this function, so then we will get two value for L and K. So we are going to put it into indirect profit function. So L will become function a new L, what we'll resolve, solve from here will be function of P, W and R. So new L will be function of P, W and R. Similarly, your K will be, you will get in terms of W, R and P. Now we will put this into new profit function, which will be equal to P into F K star L star minus W L star minus R K star. Now if you want to find out the optimal function for this with respect to wage, and then we need to find with respect to rent and with respect to price. With respect to wage, it will give you L star. With respect to minus L star minus K star rent, and with respect to price, it will give you this F K star L star, which is effectively your Q star, which is your quantity, which is nothing but your Hodling lemma. So now this is our expenditure function, and our objective is to minimize it and given the utility. So we have to keep this utility constant and minimize this expenditure function. So we need to find the minimum of this expenditure function, which is subject to your constant utility U star. We will set our Lagrange, your expenditure function, subject to your utility. When you solve this Lagrange equation, you will get value of X and value of Y. Similarly, you will get value of lambda also, but we'll just look into y and x what is here. So value of x, what we get will be in terms of px, py and u. which is your constant utility. Similarly, y also we will get in terms of px, py and u. So now this x is basically, what is this x? This is your Hixian demand. Similarly, what is this y? It is your Hixian demand for x and y. So what is your Hixian demand? Hixian demand is your compensated demand keeping your utility constants, where you keep your real income constant, and real income you measure in terms of utility in terms of Hixian demand. So this is basically your Hixian demand keeping your utility constant. You are trying to derive this x and y to minimize your expenditure. Now I'll put this Hixian demand into our expenditure function, which is px x plus py. So that is my expenditure function. This expenditure we will get as px xh plus py yh. That is our expenditure, minimize expenditure function. Now comes our Sheppard lemma. So now this is the this is the expenditure function. When we want to find out the optimum expenditure, in terms of dpx, it will give me xh, de dpy, it will give me yh. So basically, using your Sheppard lemma, what you can do, you can derive your Hixian demand. So you have your expenditure function. So this is your Sheppard lemma. Basically, this is called your Sheppard lemma. So you have your expenditure function. If you differentiate it by px, you get your Hixian demand for x. You differentiate it by py, you get your Hixian demand for y. So using your Sheppard lemma, you can also derive your Hixian demand. So let's just see the proof of Sheppard lemma. So we have our expenditure function, and this is subject to our utility, which is xy. So we'll write our Lagrange, and then we'll differentiate. So by differentiating with respect to x, y and lambda, we got these three equations. Now we'll derive it for px, py, and we'll derive x in terms of px, py and u0, and similarly y in terms of px, py, u0, using these three equations. So if you solve these three equations, you will get x and y. So by solving this equation, we got xh, which is your Hixian demand, py, u0, divided by px to the power half. Similarly, we got Hixian demand for y and lambda h. Now we will substitute this xh, yh into original expenditure function, which is px x plus py y. So we'll put Hixian demand here and see. So this is the expenditure function which I got by putting our Hixian demand. So 2 into px, py, u0, half. Now what we are going to see, our Sheppard lemma, according to our Sheppard lemma, dE by dpx should be xh. So we'll differentiate it with respect to px and see. So if you differentiate it with respect to px, you get py u0 divided by px to the power half, which is basically equal to this function you can see here. So this is your xh, Hixian demand for x. Similarly, if you do dE by dpy, you will get for yh. So that proves your Sheppard lemma. So your Sheppard lemma says that if you differentiate with respect to x, that gives your Hixian function xh. If you differentiate expenditure with respect to price y, it will give you yh. So that is proved by the above function. So that is the Sheppard lemma example we saw. Now next we are going to see the duality in and the envelope theorem. So now you know you have your consumer expenditure function, where you want to minimize it. Similarly, if it is your indirect utility function, that is your maximum value function. So those two are your dual problems, your consumer expenditure function is your minimum value function and your indirect utility function are your maximum value function. So an expenditure function is specify the minimum expenditure required to obtain a fixed level of utility given the utility function and price of consumption good. At opposite to that, your indirect utility function specifies the maximum utility that can be obtained given price, income and utility function. So basically, when your indirect utility function, when you try to maximize your utility function, and then you write equation as, then you write equation as you can see on the screen, it as you will be maximizing utility with respect to your income constraint. So that gives you, when you resolve for this Lagrange equation, when you solve for this, you will get an x and maximum x and y, which will be your Marshallian demand function. And when you go for expenditure minimization problem, where your expenditure, which is your Px(x) plus Py(y), you want to minimize this expenditure with respect to your constant utility, which we just saw. If you solve this, you will get your Hicksian demand. So basically, when you are trying to derive your utility, when you derive for utility maximization problem, you get your Marshallian demand. When you are trying your expenditure minimization problem, you get your Hicksian demand. So duality, when you try this, your Marshallian demand, which is the function of your income and your price, and Hicksian demand, which is function of your utility, constant utility and price, at duality it is equal. So if you want to maximize your utility, or if in terms of production function, if you want to maximize your production with constraint of your expenditure or your capital, that gives you maximization of output. And duality of this, when you want to minimize your expenditure, constraint is at the given output, that is your expenditure minimization problem. So that is a duality. You are dealing with the primal demand, you are dealing here with the dual demand. So that is all we have in today's envelope theorem. So what we saw, what is envelope theorem? So what we saw, how in envelope theorem, in your maximum value function, which is your indirect objective function, it gives you one envelope of set of optimized objective function generated by varying the parameter of the model. So basically that gives your envelope theorem, and what it says that only the direct effects of a change of variable need to be considered. Any indirect effect which we saw are basically any change is zero. So it only, your optimum function only depends on your direct parameter. So that we saw what is envelope theorem. We saw how do we prove the envelope theorem. Then we saw application of envelope theorem, basically the which is the function, or you can say the extension or part of envelope theorem, which is your, what is your Hotelling lemma. We saw how to prove it and what it is. We also saw what is Seifert lemma, how to prove it and what it is. And then similarly, after we resolve the one problem using Seifert lemma, and then we also saw what is duality using envelope theorem. So this is it for today's class. Thank you for watching. Goodbye till the next time. Thank you.